Hello friends, welcome to Civil Today. Strengthen your base, build right. Daily we will see different types of structures like buildings, flyovers and bridges, etc. You think in all the structures the type of support is same? The answer is no. So today in this video we will see different types of supports in civil engineering, where we use those supports with examples. First we will see types of supports in civil engineering. There are mainly four types of supports: simple support, roller support, hinged support and fixed support. Now we will see in detail how these supports are different from each other. First is simple support. There is only one reaction force, that is in vertical direction. So it can resist only vertical load. It means it cannot resist horizontal load and the moment. It is free to move in horizontal direction and it is free to rotate. Next is roller support. This is also same as that of a simple support. In this also there is only one reaction force, that is in vertical direction. So it can resist only vertical load. It is free to rotate and it can move in horizontal direction. It cannot resist horizontal load and the moment. The difference between simple support and roller support is that in roller support the rolling friction is neglected. Next is hinged support. In hinged support, there are two reaction forces, that is in vertical and horizontal direction. It means it can resist vertical and horizontal loads coming on it, but it is free to rotate because the moment is cannot be resisted by it. Next is fixed support. In this, the reaction forces are vertical and horizontal direction and also moment. So in fixed support, it can resist all types of loads, that is vertical, horizontal and moment which is coming on it. Even it cannot move in horizontal, vertical direction and it cannot be even rotated. All these types of supports have their own importance. Now we'll see where we use this type of support with examples. First is simple support. As we saw, the reaction is always normal to the support. This type of support is mainly used to transfer the point load from the beam structure to the column structure. It is mainly seen in some ancient temples and some bridges. In some ancient temples, the stones are just placed over another vertical stone which acts as a column through which the point load can be transferred, and in some bridges also simple support can be seen. Next is roller support. In this also the reaction is always normal to the support, but in this the rolling friction is neglected. The roller support is mainly seen in some bridges and crane structures. To understand how roller support works, you can see one of the best example is the sliding door. In this, every time we push a door, the support allows to move horizontal and it rotates, but it does not move vertical. It means vertically resisted. This is the best example for roller support. Next is hinge support. In this, as we saw, the end of the support is fixed, but it is free to rotate. It means it cannot resist movement. The hinge support is mainly seen in some bridges and arch structures. The roller support and hinge support is mainly used in bridges and arch structures because this support allows the bridges to expand and contract with temperature changes, so that the bridges can be function easily in all the seasons and different types of loads coming on it. So roller and hinge supports are mainly used in most of the bridges. Next is fixed support. In this, the end of the support is fixed. So either it can be moved in any direction nor it can be rotated. If we provide fixed support, the structure is in stable condition. The best example for fixed support is almost all types of RCC buildings. These are the four main types of supports in civil engineering. We are using different types of supports in different types of structures. Okay, that's the video guys. If you like the content, like and share the video and subscribe to Civil Today and press the bell icon for more such videos. Thank you for watching.